Isometric and isotonic type of muscle contractions can easily be demonstrated. For example, if I'm trying to lift the heavy weight, for example, 20 kilo, it's very difficult for me to lift up the 20 kilo weight with the single hand, whereas it's easy, the weight become reduced to the 5 kilo with the single hand. So this is called isometric and isotonic type of contractions. The work done is seen in the isotonic type of contraction because the force into displacement is the product of the work done. Isometric means the same muscle length, whereas the isotonic means the same muscle tension. Of course, tension increases, but not beyond certain limits in the isotonic type of contraction, whereas the length of the muscle fiber will not change in the isometric and decreases the length in the isotonic type of contraction, and the tension remains increases in the isometric, whereas no change in the isotonic type of contraction after certain limits, and the sarcomere length will not decreases in the isometric, so no muscle length change, whereas the reverse process seen in the isotonic type of contraction, where the muscle length is significantly decreases, so muscle fiber decreases, and no external work done seen in the isometric type of contraction, whereas external work done is obvious in the isotonic type of contraction. Examples are the in the isometric is pushing the walls and trying to lift the heavy weights, and especially the stretching of the body after getting up from the sleep and the rest in the lower animals is the best example of isometric type of contraction, whereas the lifting of the low weights and the dynamic exercises are the best example of the isotonic type of contractions. These are the basic differences between the isometric and the isotonic type of contractions in our body.